students, it is video 4 for week 4 and lecture 8. In this video, we will review the book. We review the attributes of the Holy Quran in terms of its syntax, fine, and understanding about the ayats and the other logic that has been expressed in the Holy Quran. First thing that must be kept in mind, that Quran is not a book about any exclusive subject. This is only exclusive for Hidayah. Fine. Secondly, this book has been revealed by the Almighty Allah, which is the ultimate source of knowledge beyond this ordinary worldly knowledge. Let's have understanding that Quran is divided into 30 parts. They are called paras, means and there are 114 almost 114 surahs, mean chapters, portions and chapters, 114 surahs, clear, and almost 6,666 ayats, means sentences, exist in Holy Quran, and almost over 3 lakh words the text of Quran comprised. But technically we'll see. Okay, one thing in linguistical point of view, Quran is not written in scientific manner. It has neither written in terms of poetry. It is neither a course like a mathematical word problem. It is something beyond this. Clear? It almost contains all the stylistics in it. It has rhetoric, it have a style of narration, it has anecdotes, fine. It is its word choice, rhyme and rhythm, everything is there very much. Even no book of the world can be so comprehensive as the Holy Quran is. Coming to the main focus, that as you know, that a sentence is made up of words, and subject, mean noun, verb, adverbs, adjectives, mean the parts of speech, make the are the basic of the construction of the sentence. Fine. Here, after the words, for example, Tabarak Allazi biyadi hi al-mulk wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Clear? This entire string of words, it is one ayat and one sentence. So there are three levels in it. Ayat, sentence, and verse. Fine, there are three things are used in this way. Remember this, that the word verse is used for a line of poetry. Clear? For example, among the beast, man is the worst. Clear? And just like if you read about any lines of the poetry by any writer, in English we say a verse. But Quran ayah is not verse. It is ayat. Ayat mean nishani. Ayat mean some most authentic thing by the Allah Almighty. Clear? To understand this, that Quran's ayats, Quran sentences, are not the ordinary information. It is not a chaotic flow of mind. It is not abstract ideas. This is not the blurry concepts of the poets. Fine. Quran is something extraordinary, logical and scientific and reasonable. To understand that what logic is there, that all the sentences of Quran are basically the facts, that whatever we have studied, that it tells about the history, geography, science, human anatomy, human psyche, and everything. Whatever you have studied in the video third, that were the subject matter of Quran, they are the subject matter of this. Fine. So, then when different ayahs get together, they become ruku. Ruku is just like a chapter. Ruku is just like, sorry, paragraph. Ruku is like a paragraph. And surat is a chapter. So these are the divisions of the Quran. I mean, ayats, rukus, surat, and portions or chapters. Then all the surats are divided into manzil. Clear? They are the divisions of the Quran. Other thing is, understanding the terms of Quran in easiest way. Look at this. You just imagine that when you read ordinary paragraph or essay, in the reading strategies, that a essay is the combination of different sentences which has a topic sentence. An essay is the combination of different sentences about one topic which has a main sentence, and the others are the supporting sentences that elaborate the main concept. This is very important. Ke paragraph ko zara zehn mein rakhiyega. Pehle to ab jumle ko dekhen ke alfaz ka aisa majmua jiske zariye hum apni baat bayan kar dein, jise ko baat samajh aa jaye, ko jumla tartib paaye, wo jumla hota hai. Clear? In Arabic, in Quran, this ayat, in terms of is jagah aap dekhiyega, in terms of grammar, this ayat is a sentence. Clear? And this entire, just below this commentary, these all are the sentences. They are all paragraphs. Clear? Mean all paragraph. And the combination of one paragraph, and the definition of a paragraph, that where one concept is over. Clear? In one paragraph, one concept is dealt. Clear? And these all the terms you must keep in mind. The people who are having better understanding of Urdu or English linguists, that concept is the basic one. Now read that all the concepts, all the sentences are, have some information. All the sentences are statements, and all the statements have some information. For instance, let's say we say that Pakistan is situated in South Asia. Sentence one. Second sentence, you say that Pakistan came into being on August 14, 1947. Clear? Then some person says that the total budget of Pakistan for the year 2019 to 2020 was 3,000 crore rupees. Clear? I mean, for example, fine. And then a sentence is 2 plus 2 make 4. Another sentence is that the Atlantic is the biggest and the deepest ocean on the earth. These are all the sentences that I have explained. Well, now define that when we say that Pakistan is situated in South Asia, is the statement is a fact. It is called geographical fact. Okay. Second statement, Pakistan came into being on August 1947. it is a fact, but historical fact with timeline means statistical fact. When we say that Atlantic is the deepest and the ocean, it is also a fact regarding the marine sciences, plus it is the fact of the geography. So in Quran Kareem, whenever something is expressed, these facts actually has been expressed from science and technology, from human being, psyche, religion, history, geography, these facts actually become the ayats. Okay, just like the topic sentence, Tabarakalladhi biyadihi al-mulku wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir, that highly peaceful and highly, I'm just getting the word, babarkat, full of blessing, highly blessed is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has all the authority of the countries, who controls everything. I mean, he is the only controller and the master of the universe. وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ, and he is the only who has power and control over everything. Now, consider that this is topic sentence. Clear? And now to prove this hypothesis, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, نِلَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْسَّمَاوَاتِ خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاتِ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا, کہ جس نے موت اور زندگی کو اس لیے پیدا کیا کہ تمہیں آزمائے کہ تم میں سے اچھے اعمال کون کرتا ہے اور وہ غالب اور بخشنے والا ہے. So it is again the explanation of this sentence, as in the paragraph writing you say that the best paragraph is that restates the topic sentence. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has restated tabarakallazi biyadihi al-mulku wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Clear? Nillazi khalaqa al-maut wal hayat liyabluwakum ayyukum ahsanu amala wa huwa al-azizul ghafur. Okay, now see that this is the restatement of the paragraph, and then we come that what type of sporting sentence Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given. The first logical sentence from the field of we say astronomy, alladhi khalaqa sab'a samawatin tibaq, that who has created seven skies above each other, ma tara fi khalqi ar-rahmani min tafawut, and you won't be able to seek any error in the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Clear? Farji'il basar. Clear? And you just look towards it over and again, and you find that hal tara min futur, is there any error, is there any wrong angle, any defect in it? Clear? Then summarja al basar karratayn yanqalib ilayka al basar khasiyan wa huwa khasir, that you should keep on experimenting it from various angles, and every time your look will be will not find anything and will be tired extremely. Mean, and then see it. The next fact, وَلَكَدْ زَيَّنَ السَّمَاءَ الدُّنْيَا بِمَصَابِيهَا وَجَعَلْنَهَا رَجُومًا لِشَيَاطِينِ وَعَتَدْنَا لَهُمْ عَذَابَ السَّعِيرِ, that indeed we have embellished the first sky, the sky we are watching, with the stars, just like the lamps. Clear? And not just their lamps, but there is Shahab-e-Saqib, that there is a bullet of fire that comes out of this, and they kill the Saturn genies that who go to sky for the information. Okay, next. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ عَذَابُ جَهَنَّمْ وَبِعْسَ الْمَصِيرُ, that those who are now here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given another point, that those who jo apne rab ke sath kufr karte hain unke liye jahannam hai, that is the first mean the worst thing. Another concept has been introduced is ul-kufiya sami'ula shayka wa hiya tafur. When they will be put in it, it will be it's in extreme vigor and power, and it will be just like what we say lava that emits from. Clear? So, dear students, you find out that these ayats are there in the Holy Quran, clear, to support the idea. Meaning this entire surah, you will find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has expressed his concept, Tabarak allazi biyadi al-mulku wa huwa ala kulli shayin qadir, and then has proved this hypothesis, his claim through various aspects. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings example from the practical life, from the astronomy, from within the us, clear. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are so many ayahs. Look at this, that this is another evidence which has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expressed. هُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ زَلُولًا فَمْشُوا فِيهَا مَنَاكِبِهَا وَكُلُوا مِنْ رِزْكِهِ وَإِلَيْهِ النَّشُورِ. That he is the one who has harnessed the earth for you and has created the paths in it so that you may walk and live your life and eat, and وَإِلَيْهِ النَّشُورِ, and one day you will have to come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stand before him. Dear students, I have explained that just like you read, if you apply this methodology, that this is the main concept in the surah and here are the evidences, and you can analyze those evidences. Somewhere there are good news for the people, somewhere Allah is referring to people who have believed, and some were non-believers, some references about Jannah, some hypotheses, questions, rhetoric questions. There are so many things. Thank you very much.